Welcome dear student and Jai Swaminarayan. In the previous video, we were discussed about the atoms. What is an atom? We know that the smallest particle of the matter or the smallest particle of the element is called the atoms. So element is made up of the atoms. So element here made up of the same atoms or a different atoms. So one element is made up of the atoms. So atom is the smallest particle of the element which has its a chemical property, right? So atoms of the same element are a same, but atoms of the different element are a different, right? So in the previous video we were discussed about the symbol of the atoms of the different element, how we can represent the atoms of the different element, like a hydrogen. For the hydrogen we represent the only H. For the helium we represent a He, right? So the atom can be represented by a symbol, first letter or a first two letter of the name of the element, right? So for example, so if we want to represent the oxygen atom, we use a only first letter of the oxygen, capital O, right? First letter should always should be represented by a capital letter, right? And if you use a two letter, right, for example helium, right, helium can be represented by a He, right? So for this two letter representation, first letter is a capital and the second letter is a lowercase letter, small letter, right? So in the previous video we were discuss about the atoms cannot exist independently, right? Atoms can be forms a molecule. Several atoms combines the molecule. So same atoms combines the molecules. Different atoms of the different elements combines to form a molecules, right? So dear student, in this video we will discuss about what is the molecules, how the molecules are formed by the different atoms, right? How the molecules are formed by the same atoms of the same element, atoms of the different elements. So molecules of the elements, molecules of the compound, right? And then further we will discuss in this video what is molecules of the ions, right? What are the different types of the ions present in the molecules? So let us start with the what is a molecules. So first of all, a molecule is the smallest particle of the element or a compound which exists independently and shows all the property of that substance. So here dear student, the molecules are made up of the atoms, right? A molecules is the smallest particle of the compound which exists independently. Atoms cannot exist independently, but here the molecules can exist independently, and the molecule shows the all the properties of the substance, right? So a molecule is the smallest particle of the compound which exists independently, and that shows the all the properties of that substance, right? So a molecule is a group of two or more elements that are held together by a strong attractive force. Two or more atoms of the elements that are attracted by an attractive force, right, that are held by an attractive force to form a molecule. So dear student, here the molecule is nothing but the several combination of the atoms of the two or more elements, right? Understand? So a molecule is a group of a two or more elements. Element consists the atoms. So we can say that like this also, a molecule is a group of two or more atoms that are held together by a strong attractive force. So attractive force are exerting between the two atoms of the elements, right, to form a molecule. So atoms of the same element or a different elements can join together to form a molecules. So here the molecules can be formed by a group of two or more atoms, right, of the same element as well as of the different element, right? So atoms of the same element or different element can join together to form a molecule. So in the molecules, both the more than two atoms are there, right, and all the atoms are of the same element or all the atoms are of a different element. It can be a from the same element, it can be a from the different elements. For example, if you consider the molecules of the nitrogen, nitrogen is represented by N2. So molecules of the nitrogen element join with the other molecules of the atoms of the nitrogen join with the atoms of the another nitrogen to form the nitrogen molecules, right? Molecule of the nitrogen. So one molecule of the nitrogen consists the two nitrogen atom. So here this see this figure, right? Here in the nitrogen molecules, two atom of the nitrogen elements are there. Similarly, if we considering a hydrogen, right, H2, we can represent hydrogen by a H2. So in the hydrogen, two atoms of the hydrogen combines joined together to form the hydrogen molecules. Similarly, oxygen atom, two atoms of the oxygen combine join and together to form the oxygen molecules. Similarly, nitrogen, chlorine, right? So two molecules of the chlorine join together and forms a chlorine molecules, right? So understand, dear student. So here the atom of the same element are joined together and form a molecule. So that are the example. These are the examples of the atoms of the same element. Here the atoms of the hydrogen element and hydrogen element join together and form a hydrogen molecules of the hydrogen. Molecules, atoms of the oxygen and oxygen join together and form the oxygen molecules. Atom of the nitrogen and nitrogen join together forms the molecules of the nitrogen. We can write a N2, right? N2, that means the two atoms of the nitrogen element. Here the Cl2. So molecule, atoms of the chlorine Cl join with the atoms of the another chlorine, we get the molecules of the chlorine Cl2. But atoms of the different element can also join together and to form a molecules. For example, if we consider the atom of the carbon and two atom of the oxygen, right? So here the atom of the carbon join with the two atoms of the oxygen forms a CO2 molecules, that is the carbon dioxide, right? So another, some other elements are that which have a single atoms, right? For example, argon, neon, krypton, xenon, it has a individual atoms, right? So here first, atoms of the different element can join together to form a molecules. For example, atoms of the nitrogen element and oxygen element joins together gives the nitrogen oxide, that is a NO. In the NO, one atom of the nitrogen and one atom of the oxygen join together to forms the nitrogen oxide, molecule of the nitrogen oxide. Similarly, simple structure, you know, the atoms of the hydrogen, two atoms of the hydrogen molecule, hydrogen element H and H join with the one atom of the oxygen, we get the H2O, molecule of the water, right? That is the chemical formula of the molecule of the water, is the H2O. So in the H2O, two atom of the two hydrogen elements, two atom of the hydrogen elements join with the one atom of the oxygen element. So the chemical formula of the water is a H2O. So in this H2O, two atoms of the hydrogen present and one atom of the oxygen present. So in the water molecules, the three atoms are present, two of the hydrogen and one is the oxygen, right? Similarly, nitrogen dioxide, right? In the molecules of the nitrogen dioxide, nitrogen atoms join with the two atom of the oxygen to form a nitrogen dioxide, molecule of the nitrogen dioxide. Similarly, carbon dioxide, you know that carbon atom of the carbon joined with the two oxygen atom forms a molecule of the carbon dioxide. So dear student, understand how the molecules forms, right? Atom of the same element or a different element can join together by a strong attractive force to form a molecules, right? So the attractive force between the different molecules are different, that you will study in the higher standard, right? So now, dear student, we will discuss the molecules of the elements. So in the molecules, there are one atoms are there, two atoms are there, and three atoms are there, and more than three atoms are there. So we can divide elements in the molecules in the content of the atom present in the element, or we can say that the atomicity of the element. So molecules of the an element contains the atom of the same element, right? Molecules of the same some elements contains only one atom, molecules of the some element contains the two atoms, and molecules of the some element contains the more than two atoms. So if the molecules are made up of the atoms of the same element, it contains the one atom, it contains the two atom, or it contains the more than two atom. So similarly, according to the atomicity of the element, we can divide the molecules in the three different categories, right? Monoatomic molecule, diatomic molecule, and polyatomic molecule. So atomicity, what do you mean by the atomicity of the element? Atomicity of the element is the number of atom present in the one molecule of the element, right? So here, if you consider this non-metals and the metals, right? What is the non-metals? Non-metals is the poor conductor of the electricity and heat, and the metals are the good conductor of the electricity and heat, right? So if you consider the atomicity of the molecules, what is the atomicity of the molecules? The atomicity of the molecules is the number of atom present in the one molecule of the element, right? So one molecule, how many number of the atoms are present in the one molecules is called the atomicity of the element, right? So in the some molecules, there is only one atom present. In the some molecules, there are more than one atom are present. And according to this, the molecules are divided into the three categories: monoatomic molecules, diatomic molecules, and polyatomic molecules. So if there is only one atom present in the molecules is called the monoatomic molecules, right? If there is two atom present in the molecules is called the diatomic molecules. And if there are more than two atoms are present in the element, the molecules are called the polyatomic molecules. So according to the atomicity of the molecules, right, the molecules are divided into the three categories: monoatomic molecules. So examples of the monoatomic molecules are argon, helium, right, are the examples of the monoatomic molecule. In the one molecule of the argon, only one atom is present of the argon. Helium, in the one molecule of the helium, only one helium atom is present. Similarly, example of the monoatomic molecules are metals. In the metals, sodium Na, right, iron Fe, aluminium Al, copper Cu are the example of the monoatomic molecules. So what are the monoatomic molecules? The monoatomic molecules are the molecules in that the only one atom is present. So dear student, understand what is monoatomic molecules and what are the example of the monoatomic molecules. Now, diatomic molecules. What is the diatomic molecules? If there is a two atom present in the one molecule, the molecule is called the diatomic molecules. For example, oxygen. In the oxygen molecule, there are two atoms of the oxygen are present, right? Hydrogen. In the hydrogen atom, two atom of the hydrogen are present. In the nitrogen molecules, two atom of the nitrogen are present. In the chlorine molecules, two atom of the chlorine are present. So these all are the example of the diatomic molecules. So diatomic molecules are the molecules in which two atoms are present in the molecules, right? And if the molecules if there are more than two atoms present in the molecules are called the polyatomic molecules, right? For example, phosphorus. So in the phosphorus, there are 4 atoms of the phosphorus are present in the phosphorus molecules, right? To form a molecule of the phosphorus, 4 atoms of the phosphorus are present. So phosphorus is the example of the polyatomic molecules. Similarly, sulfur are the example of the polyatomic molecules. So understand, dear student, what is the monoatomic molecules, what are the example of the monoatomic molecules, what is diatomic molecules, what are the example of the diatomic molecules, and what is polyatomic molecules, and what are the example of the polyatomic molecules, right? So these are the molecules from the elements, right? Now, molecules of a compound. So molecules of the compound contains the atom of the two or different type of the element. So in the molecules of the elements, so atoms, molecules of the element contains the only one atoms, right, of the same element, right? So here, if we consider the oxygen, so oxygen combined with the oxygen atom, right? So this, in the molecules of the compound, the molecules of the compound contains the atom of the two or more different type of the elements, right? For example, the hydrogen and the oxygen, right, combines together, form the two atoms of the hydrogen, and the one atom of the oxygen combines to form a molecule of the water. So here the molecules of the compound contains the atom of the two or more different types of the atom of the elements, right? For example, if we consider the water molecules, water, the chemical formula of the water is the H2O. So combining elements, but hydrogen and oxygen combines together to form a molecule of the water, right? So number of atoms in each element. So in the water, two atoms of the hydrogen and one atom of the oxygen are combined. So the molecules of the water is a polyatomic molecules. So molecules of the compounds are generally a polyatomic molecules. Similarly, ammonia contains the nitrogen and hydrogen. So in the ammonia, one atom of the nitrogen and three atoms of the hydrogen combines to form the one molecule of the ammonia, right? Similarly, carbon dioxide, CO2. So in the carbon dioxide, one atom of the carbon combines with the two atoms of the oxygen gives the one molecule of the carbon dioxide. Hydrochloric acid, HCl. So in the one molecule of the hydrochloric acid HCl, one atom of the hydrogen and one atom of the chlorine is present, right? Nitric acid, HNO3. So in that nitric acid, three different elements combine together to form a one molecule of the nitric acid: hydrogen, nitrogen and oxygen. So nitric acid contains the one atom of the hydrogen, one atom of the nitrogen and three atoms of the oxygen, right? Similarly, sulfuric acid contains the three different elements: hydrogen, sulfur and oxygen. So in the sulfuric acid, two atoms of the hydrogen are present, one atom of the sulfur and four atoms of the oxygen are present. So understand, dear student, molecules of the compound contains the atom of the two or more different types of the element, right? So different types of the atoms are combined together with the attractive force to form the molecules of the compound. Understand? So dear student, now we will discuss the atomic mass present in the molecules, right? The mass of the atom present in the molecules, atomic mass of the elements present in the molecules with the help of the one activity. So let us understand the mass of the atom present in the molecules and the atomic mass of the element with the help of the activity. So consider this table: molecules of the some compound, water, ammonia and carbon dioxide. So in the water, we know that the elements are present in the molecule of the water are hydrogen and oxygen, right? Ammonia, nitrogen and hydrogen. Carbon dioxide, carbon and oxygen, right? So the ratio of the mass of the atoms present in the molecules and the table number 3.2, the atomic mass of the element. Find the ratio of the number of atoms of the element in the molecules of the compound in the table. So here, if you consider the hydrogen element, two elements of the hydrogen are present in the molecules of the water, and one atom of the oxygen are present. So here we know that what is the mass of the hydrogen? Mass of the hydrogen is a 1. So for example, if we contain the molecules of the water, in the molecules of the water, the hydrogen, two atoms of the hydrogen are present and one atom of the oxygen are present. So here, if we consider the mass of the hydrogen, so mass ratio by a mass, mass of the hydrogen is a 1 amu. So if we take a ratio, it is a 2 atoms of the hydrogen. So we get a mass of the hydrogen is a 2 amu. Right? Now, oxygen, 1 atom of the oxygen. So what is the mass of the oxygen? Mass of the oxygen is a 16 amu. Right? So if you take a ratio 8/16, we get a 1/2. Right? So the ratio of the number of atoms for the water is H2O is a 2 raised to 1, right? So two atoms are present in the hydrogen atoms are present in the water molecules, and the one oxygen atoms are present in the water molecules, right? Similarly, if we considering the ratio of mass, so ratio of mass is a 1 raised to 8, right? So ratio of mass is a 1 raised to 8. So 1 raised to 8, if you multiply a 1/2 divided by 8/2, we get a 1/16, right? So similarly, from that mass ratio also, we get the HgMO ratio is a 2:1, right? So similarly, nitrogen, the mass ratio of the nitrogen is 14:3. So in the ammonia, we know that what is the ammonia contains the 1 atom of the nitrogen and the 3 atom of the hydrogen. So if you consider the nitrogen 1, the mass of the nitrogen is a 14, right? And mass of the hydrogen is a 1, right? So we get a 3 hydrogen. So the ratio of the nitrogen to the hydrogen is a 14/3. So dear student, understand, same way we can calculate carbon dioxide. In the carbon dioxide, 1 molecule of the carbon present and 2 molecules of the oxygen are present. So here the mass of the carbon is a 6 and the mass of the oxygen is a 16, right? So if you take a ratio, we get the 3:8, right? So this way we can understand the mass of the atom present in the molecules, right? Now dear student, ions, what do you mean by the ions? The compound contains the metal and non-metal elements, contains the charged particles. So if you consider the any molecules of the compound, it contains the charged particle, positive charged particle as well as the negative charged particle. So here the compound contains the compound of molecules of the compound contains the charged particle, and this charged particle is called the ions. So if we consider the molecules of the compound element, either metal or non-metal, it contains the some amount of the charged particle, and this charged particle is called the ion. So an ion is a charged particle having a positive or a negative charge, right? So what do you mean by the ion? So ion is a charged particle having a charge, either positive charge or a negative charge. So a positively charged particle is called the cation. A positively charged ion is called the cation, and a negatively charged ion is called the anion, right? So from the valency of the element, so what do you mean by the valency? Valency of the compound is the combining capacity of the element. How much more atoms are combined together with the atom of the element is called the valency of the element. So valency is nothing but the combining capacity of the element. How much more atoms are combining with the other elements, atom of the elements, is called the valency of the atom. For example, if we considering a sodium, we can write a valency 1, because sodium has a only one atom and it has a capacity of combining the other one element, right? Similarly, potential has a valency 1. It has a capacity of combining the one other element. So we can write, if we can consider the sodium has a combining capacity of the 1. So valency of the sodium is a 1. So we can take a Na plus, right? Plus, that means it has a positive charge. And Na plus, a positively charged ion is called the cation. So these all are the positively charged ion has a capacity of combining capacity of a 1. So it has a valency 1. Similarly, positive cation, if we considering a magnesium, calcium, zinc, iron, copper, this has a combining capacity of a 2 elements with the atom of the copper. So atom of the magnesium has a capacity of combining the other 2 atoms, right? So it has a valency 2, right? So this all the positive cation has a valency 2. Similarly, this aluminium and iron, aluminium Al plus 3 has a valency 3, Fe plus 3 has a valency 3. So this may be asked in your examination, what is the valency of the aluminium, what is the valency of the zinc, right? What are the cations, what are the anions, right? Give the example of the cations, that all the things you must have to remember, right? So here the sodium, potassium, silver, copper has the valency 1. So it has a combining capacity one more atom with this element, right? Calcium, zinc, iron has a combining capacity 2, valency 2. So it has a capacity of combining the 2 more atom with the elements. And aluminium ion has a combining capacity 3. So it has a valency 3. Similarly, hydrogen, hydride, chloride, bromide, iodide, oxide, right, has a different valency. So hydrogen has a valency 1. We can write a H plus, and hydride has a valency minus. So it has, if the hydrogen contains the negative charge, it is a anion, right? So it is called the hydride. Chlorine, in the chlorine atom there will be a negative charge. So chlorine is a anion. So different element has a different capacity, combining capacity of the atom, and it is called the valency of the atom. So remember this, all the valency of the atom. So for example, ammonium. So if you consider the ammonium, it has a minus 1. Valency is a minus 1. Nitrate, valency of the nitrate is a minus. Hydrogen carbonate has a valency minus. Carbonate, CO3 minus 2, it has a valency minus 2. So remember, dear student, the valency of all the different ions, common ions, right? It may be asked in your examination also. So dear student, understand what is the ion, what is the cation, what is the anion, what is the valency, and what is the valency of the different ions, right? So what is the ion? An ion is a charged particle having a positive or a negative charge. It contains the charged particle, positive charge and the negative charge, either in the molecules of the compound of the containing the metals as well as in the non-metals element. So ions are divided into the two categories, positively charged ion and the negatively charged ion. Positively charged ion is called the cation and the negatively charged ion is called the anion, right? Some elements, some ions and their valency. So what do you mean by the valency? Valency is the combining capacity of the elements. How many number of the more atoms are combining with the atoms, right? Is called the valency of the atoms, right? So valency of the different atoms is a different. So you have to remember this valency of all the elements. And you have to remember this valency of all the elements. So in the future, right, in the next chapter, that is a very important to know the valency of the different element, how we can write the chemical formula of the any elements, right? The valency is the most important thing. So dear student, remember this valency of all the common ions, right?